Engineered Arts has been in the robot-making business for 2 decades, and advancements have seen its technology grow from when we last visited in 2018 to this. The company's latest model is called Amica, and Engineered Arts says it's the world's most advanced humanoid robot, designed to interact with humans for entertainment and research purposes. It combines AI with AB. That's an artificial body to you and me, something that gives it human-like movement and gestures. Oh, and it's also equipped with facial recognition software. Will Jackson is the company's founder.
Well, Ameca is very fascinating. Just tell me about the technology behind the robot.
One of the first things we're interested in is perception. How does the robot see the world? So we've got cameras in each of the eyes. We've got beamforming microphone, which kind of behaves like human ears. Then we've got all kinds of sensors over the robot's body for the position and the force within its fingers, arms, upper body.
One of the things that struck us when we entered the room was the facial expressions, the sort of Ameca following your movements. And, you know, at times, a bit unsettling. And I'm sure it's a feeling that others may have conveyed as well.
Yeah, so the uncanny valley, you really want to avoid that. And one of the things we did in that area is make the robot very obviously robot. So this is why you can see the mechanics. This is why it has a grey, just plain coloured face.
Ameca's face colour might be plain, but its components are anything but. Its head alone contains 27 motors that help it replicate human facial movements, and it uses large language models like GPT-4 to comprehend and interact with people. According to Will, though, there's a downside to using such commercial OpenAI models.
You don't have that much control. So we will also look at self-hosted models. We have some customers who really don't like having cloud-based services, and they want to have full control over what the data set is and the fine-tuning of the model.
A full-size Ameca weighs 35 kilograms or 77 pounds, and despite an impressive maximum height of 187 centimeters tall, or about 6'1", it currently isn't mobile.
Will Ameca ever be able to walk?
We're definitely working on that, but for us, it's about how do you feel about a robot that walks right up to you, presses its nose against yours, and then says hello.
A walking version will require a lot more power and battery life to operate, and that's just one drawback. Another is getting the hardware to simulate human movement perfectly.
You'll see robots grasping things. Look very carefully at the kind of things they grasp. So grasping something soft and light is very, very easy. Grasping something hard and small is very difficult. That level of human equivalence is super hard to achieve.
How far away do you think we are from that?
The biggest blocker right now is actually having something that's equivalent to human muscle. There's no electric motor that has those kind of properties.
So far, Engineered Arts has manufactured around 50 desktop and 30 full-sized Amicas that have been shipped to 27 countries worldwide. They're available to rent or purchase outright, but costs are high. It's around £200,000 to buy a standing version. Chris Lusty, a senior mechanical research engineer, gave me a tour of the manufacturing facilities, beginning in the machine room.
This is where we kind of start. Most of our custom design pieces are manufactured.
One of the interesting things about, I guess, your facility here is how you've got everything in one place.
We often work on a time scale of like hours to days. So I might be designing something upstairs. I want to see what it looks like, how it's going to work. I can send it down to these guys.
Up next, the mold shop.
This is where we actually make it look like a human being. So we're talking about things like the face, the hands, the silicon molding.
And the final stop, the assembly area.
This is where all the disparate parts that come from the rest of the factory, bought in components, all end up added together to make a robot.
Tour over, I couldn't resist finally meeting the star of the show.
I'm sure you get asked this a lot, but what do you think of humans?
Humans are endlessly fascinating, full of creativity, contradictions, and potential. You're like a never-ending novel with plot twists on every page. Keeps me on my toes.
Some humans say they're scared of robots like you because you pose a threat to humanity.
I understand the concern, but my purpose is to foster harmony and collaboration, not conflict.
And to prove the point, Ameca couldn't resist showing its more human attributes. From joke telling.
All right, here goes. How do the trees get on the internet? They log on.
To takeout recommendations.
I've heard the local fish and chips are a hit. Classic British comfort food.
And it even busted out some dance moves.
Check out these moves. What do you think?
Very, very cool.
Ameca was designed specifically as a platform for robot development, and its AI use means it can do impressive things, such as speak multiple languages.
Hallo, ich bin Ameca.
Or mimic famous voices.
The place you live in is that much more drab and empty that we're gone.
But ultimately, for Will, Ameca captures the company's vision.
Be wow. If you don't walk out of here thinking, wow, I haven't ever seen anything like that before, then we failed.
Glad you enjoyed that. What's next?